A mind that is stronger than iron, that shines like a light in the dark, and a body that could wrestle a lion, and then deal out a witty remark. He has so very many astounding attributes.
He's noble and courageous.
He looks excellent in suits.
Yes, a seamless blend of dreaminess,
experience,
and genius.
These are the ingredients you need. When you're making a man, making a hero, quick as we can. The nation's in need of a marvelous man, a dependable dreamboat, a shining example of what humans can be. So we're making a man. Okay. Step one, thinking caps on. Gotta pull a fast one, fast on the hun. Gotta find a corpse.
A dead man.
Of course. Can we gather a cadaver from the local morgue?
Charles, this is a secret mission. We can't go raising any suspicion. Luckily, I know the perfect man to help us hatch this plan.
Welcome to London.
We are Cockneys.
This is what Cockneys wear. Bodies. What you know about bodies?
Nothing at all.
Well, if you need information about expiration, there's only one man that you should call. He knows the ropes.
He knows the knives.
He knows all ways of ending lives. It's Spilsbury. Spilsbury. Introducing Bernard Spilsbury.
So you say you want the perfect body.
Spilsbury.
I've got every kind that you could need.
Sir Bernard Spilsbury.
Old ladies to adolescents, in all stages of putrescence. So come inside and see what you can see. Don't delay or they'll decay. Come on, fellas, step this way. And feast your eyes on all my lovely bodies.
Spilsbury!
Take a look, I've quite the repertoire.
Sir Bernard Spilsbury!
From grandads to old biddies, young men to little kiddies. You want homicide or suicide or can't decide? Well, come inside and see.
Monty, make it stop!
Mr. Roberts choked on a yogurt. Mr. Measles mauled by weasels. If you're after buckets of gore, here's Brian. He's basically a lung in a drawer.
No!
It's just Brian.
Bernard, we need a chap who's fresh, of military age with undamaged flesh.
So if the Spanish do an autopsy, they certify him drowned at sea.
Have no fear, I'll find your perfect body.
Spilsbury!
I get skip loads of these stiffs each and every day.
So Bernard Spilsbury!
I'll find your dear departed. We need to get things started. Or my name isn't Bernard Spilsbury.
O-D-E.
I'll find you your man.
Step two, leave a trail of clues. Pack a wallet with receipts so that we can prove that our Bill had a life. A man about town who splashed his cash then drowned.
And they will find that he dined at the hottest joints with the coolest cats, the swinging spots with the hot seats.
Oh, the nightlife's such a thrill.
And they will all see our boy. He had such a taste for fun.
He's dressed to impress.
Wouldn't settle for less.
34 round the chest.
Only the best for Bill.
Fight me for me, governor.
What century are you in?
Yay!
Step three, send Bill to sea.
Get him all the way to Spain in secrecy so he can wash ashore and then win us the war.
Charles, my genius, take the floor. Now, it's a good plan, Charles, but it's got to be approved by every fusty old admiral in this building.
Oh.
Good luck!
Admirals, may I present my idea for the world's first human thermos? Our Bill will sail by submarine in a giant thermos, a corpse canteen, vacuum-packed and airtight through and through.
Chop, chop, we've got a lot to do.
Suck out the oxygen so Bill won't rot.
What?
Add dry ice and he won't get hot when he's on his quest. It's only the best for Bill.
Well, what's it made of?
Stainless steel.
Won't it smell?
Well, that's why it's sealed.
What about the crew when they know there's a corpse aboard?
That's a bloody good question.
I forgot what I said.
We could say that it's equipment. It's a top secret shipment. It's need to know.
Gene, that is brilliant.
I'm quite impressed.
Only the best for Bill.
Monty, the map with the submarine's course to Huelva on it. Have you seen it?
What?
I was sure that I put it. Well, the whole file is missing.
It'll turn up.
But...
Look, the crew have their orders. They're going to Spain, Charles. It's not hard. You turn left at France, then it's straight on to Yehemaracas.
Monty, that file is confidential. If we've lost it, we could get into serious trouble.
Charlie, don't be so narrow-minded.
Well, I don't think it's narrow-minded.
Stop fretting about guidelines and rules.
This is important, Monty.
Now remember, we're His Majesty's finest.
But I don't see what it's got
And to... regulations are for cowards and fools.
But Monty, we're responsible for how this thing is done.
If we claim the final victory, who cares just how we won?
for when you write the book. My boy, you're off the hook, so just be a man, 'cause we're making a hero
quick as we can. The nation's in need of a marvelous man, a dependable dreamboat, a shining example of what humans can be. Making a man.
We're doing well, Charles, but we still don't have that damn body.
Yes, I'm aware of that fact, Monty.
I'll call Spills.
No, no, please, please don't make me see that man again.
He can't get you, you know?
Horrible, wet hat!
This is the most secure building in England, all right? There's no way he can find us here.
Lads, look here, I found your perfect bodies.
Spillsbury!
Look what fate has landed in our lap.
Spillsbury!
This homeless chap in Croydon accidentally ate rat poison, the perfect worm to bait our little trap.
He's perfect.
So he didn't drown.
Don't worry about it.
Don't they suspect?
Ha! I doubt it. Foreigners aren't great coroners, see? And no one in Spain is as clever as me. I've found your man, I've saved the day, so fetch my fee, and I'll be on my way.
Really makes you wonder about the security of the building, doesn't it?
Sirs, I finished your documentation. Our pilot officially exists.
Ugh, and the good news is, we have a body.
You've got a body?
Cooling in the freezer as we speak.
And who was he?
Oh, well, this is the best part.
Monty.
He was just some tramp.
Excuse me?
Monty. Spillsbury got him off the street. No family, no one to raise the alarm when he's gone. It's perfect.
Where is Montague?
Oh, good.
I did not hand you His Majesty's checkbook so that you could spend hundreds of pounds on jewellery, cocktails, theatre tickets.
The things I do for this country.
You are out of control.
Johnny, we need the receipts for Bill's wallet, all right?
Do you really think you're working independently? Or that your little team's the only thing that's under me? The notion that you're more than a drop in the ocean of the £100 I have in motion is enough to earn emotion. Montague, this war is bigger than you.
Please stop acting like I don't know what to do.
You're making a mockery of this whole damn operation.
You are making a mess of every decision that you're making.
You're making a spectacle.
Well, you're making it difficult to be sensible.
You're making it about you because you're bloody egotistical.
Oh my God.
No, John, wait. Just let me explain. Picture the scene.
A bachelor residing in Oval.
Here's his lease agreement.
Soon to make his way up the aisle.
They'll tie the knot next summer.
And to celebrate his recent betrothal,
a sparkling diamond ring.
They spent the night in London in style.
One night on the town.
And he took his girl to dinner and the latest West End show.
She said he looked so handsome in his suit from Savile Row.
One last night of celebration before he leaves to save this nation.
Delivering the plans of our Sardinian invasion.
With a never-ending paper trail.
A cover story that can't fail. We made him up, then made his life come true. Believe in Bill, and they'll believe him too. We've made you a man.
So, what do you think?
It's good. It's believable. But I do think it's missing one thing.
What?
He needs to be carrying a letter from his fiancée, from the girl that he loves. Soldiers don't go off to war without a reminder of why they're fighting in the first place.
Quite right. I like it.
And they'll see it there in writing that our girl, he went down fighting for his love, his life, and his democracy.
So we're making a man, making a hero, quick as we can. The nation's in need of a marvelous man, a dependable dreamboat, a shining example of what humans can be. God, that's brilliant. Really brilliant. God, that's brilliant. You'll never see it coming.